Hey everyone, it's Leela from Miss Kiss Creations. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to make a very easy beginner's alcohol ink tumbler. So first we're going to go over the materials and then we'll go ahead and get started. You're obviously going to need a tumbler, any size of your choice. I am using a 20 ounce tumbler from stainlesssteeldepot.com. I went ahead and I spray painted this tumbler white. The spray paint does not have to be perfect. As you can see, mine's not perfect. Just to get a good coat, I did use flat white spray paint on this tumbler. So have any color spray paint tumbler you like. I just chose white just to keep it simple. Secondly, you're gonna need some epoxy. I already have my epoxy mixed up here for y'all. I am using Amazing Clear Cast Epoxy. I am using 24 mls of mixed epoxy. So I mixed part A 12 mls and part B 12 mls, and I combined it to make 24 mls of mixed epoxy. You're also going to need alcohol ink. The colors I'll be using today is going to be from Tim Holtz. It's Sailboat Blue, Pool, Mermaid, and I'm also gonna try to use this alcohol pearl. It is Tranquil from Tim Holtz. Lastly, you're gonna need a heat gun. I do have a Wagner heat gun. I did purchase this from Lowe's. This heat gun was about $20 to $25. And don't forget, you're always gonna need gloves while handling spray paint, alcohol inks, and epoxy. Let's go ahead and get started. Again, I did mix up my epoxy already off camera. Now again, I mix a total of 24 mls of epoxy together. For this tumbler, you are gonna need a lot of epoxy. So this is how you get the great alcohol swirl effect. So you are gonna put what we call a flood coat on your tumbler. A flood coat is just a heavy coat of epoxy. So I'm gonna go ahead and pour the epoxy on the tumbler. There's no certain way of how you do this. You can dip your finger in the cup, you can drizzle it on the tumbler, however which way you like, it does not matter, it's gonna even out in the end. So right now I'm gonna make sure I'm getting a full coat of the epoxy on the tumbler, a full coat, and then once I have my full coat, I'm just gonna add more just to make that flood coat. Again, the flood coat is just a thicker coat of epoxy. All right, so it looks like it's spread out pretty evenly. My spray paint job did not dry all the way and I touched it. So that's why you see little specks of spray paint on the tumbler, like so. And then now I'm gonna take the rest of my epoxy and then I'm just gonna drizzle it on the tumbler and get that heavy coat. And now I'm not pressing hard. So you do not wanna press hard on the tumbler. You just want the tumbler to be coated with this flood coat. You just want a nice thick coat. So I'm just moving my finger back and forth. And I always use my gloved finger to apply epoxy on my tumbler. I find that's easier for me. All right, so a nice thick coat, like I said. And then I'm probably gonna have some left over. So you'll probably just need 20 mls of epoxy because it looks like I have some left over. So I have a heavy hand with a lot of stuff, as y'all know in my videos. All right, so now that this flood coat, what we call a flood coat, is on this tumbler, now for the fun and easy part. So I'm gonna take off my glove. So I have epoxy on it, and then I'm gonna put another glove on here because alcohol inks, they do stain. And then now I'm just gonna drip the alcohol ink onto the tumbler, like so. All I'm doing is I'm hovering over the tumbler and you just squeeze out the tip. And then it just drips onto the tumbler. Now make sure you're not hitting the the alcohol ink tip with the epoxy, because whenever I first did this a long time ago when I was just a beginner, I touched my tip on my tumbler and the epoxy touched the tip, and the next time I went to go use it, it was sealed shut, so I had to buy a new color. It was actually black. So make sure you do keep that in mind. Keep your alcohol ink away from your tumbler. I'm gonna add another blue. Let's do my sailboat. Oop, looks like I've already used that color. Let's do my pool blue. And then for the bottom, I'm just hitting just the edge of the tumbler, and it kind of drips down on the bottom. I'm trying to make it drip down on the bottom. There it goes. All right, you just do this everywhere on the tumbler. Now, I could have done the background light blue instead of white, but I wanted the white to kind of peek through of the tumbler. All right, now it doesn't look nice, so just have some patience, and you'll see the magic happen here soon. And I'm just squirting random spots of epoxy or of alcohol ink on the tumbler. I'm not thinking about it. I'm just randomly squeezing out the alcohol ink. I'm just kind of I'm trying to cover up the white. Or the background of the tumbler. And then I'm just gonna get the bottom of it. Like I said, this is a great beginner's tumbler. If you are just starting out, this is perfect for beginners. I love this tumbler. Everybody loves it. I love this style. A lot of people, they want a swirl tumbler. So this is great for beginners. It's easy and it comes out beautiful, and every single time it comes out differently. You can see it's already starting to swirl and kind of blend together. That's what you want. You want it to blend, you want it to swirl. And now if I would have put a very thin coat of epoxy on this, it wouldn't blend together, it wouldn't swirl. So I did add my pearl in here. The pearl, they're kind of metallic color. So I wanted to see what that will do. And then you just let it spin, and you just let it kind of do its thing for a couple minutes. And then once it spins for a couple minutes, you're gonna watch it change a little bit. I'm gonna try to get the bottom here. You're gonna watch it change and swirl together, and then that's whenever you'll hit it with the heat gun. Alright, so I let my tumbler spin for about a minute, and I'm going to go ahead and take my tumbler arm or my turner, and then I'm going to spin the tumbler the other way. And right now, I want some more depth to this tumbler, so I'm going to add some white to it. They do have Tim Holtz white, but I'm also using Piñata brand. So this is Piñata white, and I'm just going to add some white to here. Just to give it more depth. And I have not hit this with a heat gun. I have let it spin for about a minute and a half. So let me spin this back your way. I'm just gonna add a little bit of white to here. Now the Piñata brand, it has a thicker tip on here, so the white or the inks come out a little quicker, so you have to be careful of that if you do not already know. I know I have a white background, but I'm just gonna add the white just to let the colors blend a little more. And lighten up the kind of greens that I have, the mermaid. And this tumbler, like I said, it's perfect for beginners because of this reason. If you think it looks ugly or you're not liking it, you have so much time to change it and keep adding more colors and keep blending more colors. So this is great for beginners, and it's really hard to mess up this tumbler. Trust me. Whatever color scheme y'all choose, it's gonna be beautiful. I know it. All right, so I went ahead and added some. Now I'm gonna take my arm again. Like I said, I'm gonna spin it my way. This kind of lets the tumbler swirl in a different way, the epoxy. Now this is when I'm going to take my heat gun and I'm just going to hit it on low with my Wagner heat gun. Again, I'm going to hit my tumbler on low. You want to be careful leaving your heat gun too close to your tumbler because it's going to make the alcohol inks and the epoxy spread. So you want to hit it about 10 inches away from your alcohol ink cup, all right? So again, it's going to spread out the inks if you keep it too close to your tumbler. You're going to hit it with your heat gun for about 10 to 15 seconds. Now, I say do the heat on low because I'd rather do too little heat than too much. You don't want the colors to blend. So you just want to hit it the tumbler with just enough heat just so the epoxy can start moving a little bit. And then you'll see what I'm talking about once this spins for a couple minutes. So if you hit this with a lot of heat, these colors are going to swirl so much together, it might turn into black or muddy or just not a pretty color. So I'm going to let this spin on the camera, fast forward for about a couple minutes, and then you'll see the different changes. All right, y'all, I'm back and my tumbler's been spinning for about 25 to 30 minutes. As you can see, there's been a lot of movement in the epoxy and the alcohol inks are starting to swirl and starting to do its own thing. Have patience with this tumbler. Do not go overboard on the heat because what will happen is you'll use the heat gun and you'll say, oh my gosh, it's not moving. Why isn't it moving? And then in 20 minutes, all of your colors will swirl and combine together. So make sure you're being patient with the heat. If you put enough flood coats of epoxy on your tumbler, that will be plenty of epoxy for the tumbler to, the epoxy to swirl around. So again, be patient with your heat. Don't overheat it. Don't put the heat gun too close to the tumbler. It's gonna let the alcohol ink spread and it's not gonna have a nice swirl effect. And make sure, most importantly, is just have fun with this and be patient with this tumbler. Again, there's no way you can mess up this tumbler. Each one has its own unique look and it is beautiful. You could choose any color scheme you like. You could put purples in here, you could put pinks, blacks. As you could see, I added more white during the video. So I wasn't planning on adding white, but I did to add it a little bit more depth. So I'm gonna let this tumbler spin for about 4 to 6 hours. And then by the time it's off the spinner, it's probably gonna look a little different. So we'll be back in about 4 to 6 hours and we'll see what it looks like. All right, y'all. So I let this spin for about 4 to 6 hours. And then I went ahead and I turned off my turner and then I let it sit overnight. So this has been sitting for about 12 hours or so. It is completely dry, as you can see. So you can see how much this has changed in the 12 hours that it's spun. And you could see the metallic ink that I added on here. So this is completely dry. So you can leave this like this, or you can add a decal to here. If you do add the decal, make sure you let your tumbler sit for at least 24 hours. Add the decal and then re-epoxy it, and then you were good to go. I'm gonna keep this like this because I just like the plain design. But here it is. Again, this tumbler is a great tumbler for beginners. You can have fun with it, use any color scheme you like. If y'all have any questions, please be sure to leave me a comment, or you can reach out to me on my Instagram or Facebook. It's Miss Kiss Creations with a K. Again, thank you for watching, and I will see y'all next time.